Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. This is my Bible.
This is my Bible.
My Bible.
Is
the Word of God.
Is the Word of God.
I agree. God.
With God.
Jesus.
Jesus.
Is the author.
Is the author.
And the finisher.
And the finisher.
Of my faith.
Of my faith.
And the glory.
He's the Lord.
And the lifter.
And the lifter.
Of my head.
Of my head.
I agree. With God.
With God.
I refuse.
To be deceived. To be deceived.
In this last day.
In this last day.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
For giving me.
For giving
the
me.
The Word of Truth.
The Word of Truth.
And I don't get deceived.
That I don't get deceived.
In this last day. The devil is shrewd. He's looking for people.
He's looking for people.
That will move.
That will move.
The ancient boundary.
The ancient boundary.
So can come in.
So he can come in.
And disarrange.
And disarrange.
Everything.
Everything.
In our lives.
In our lives.
Devil.
Devil.
I have no permission. Hallelujah. Yeah, Lord is worthy.
Yeah.
Let the Bible be your guide. Let the Bible be your guide.
Amen.
It sounds very simple, but it's not that simple. We know what we want to do. Few things outside of what the Bible says. And we still want God to accommodate it. That's when you move the ancient boundaries. That's when you enlarge. The Bible says, wide is the road that leads to destruction. And many people pass through it. Why? It said narrow is the road that leads to life, and only a few find it. One thing we need to know, you can have many opinions, but you only have one truth.
Yeah.
Anytime you move the boundary from what the Bible says to accommodate it, just a little bit of what you think you want to do, you just got to change it from truth to opinion. When you change from truth to opinion, it doesn't work. Many people can have many opinions, but it's only one truth.
Amen.
It's either something is true or a lie. If you have two things, it's either both is a lie or one of it is true. It cannot be both true. So the Word of God is the truth.
Yeah.
Thing that don't matter with the Word of God is opinion.
Okay.
And the opinion don't hold no waters.
Yeah.
Amen.
Hold no water.
Amen.
I got something to tell the lawmakers, Democrat, Republican alike. I want to encourage you. Don't try to live above the law. Because it's a list of Democrats and Republicans that fall into sexual immorality. Before then, it's like some people say, well, it's not politically correct, I don't want you to mess with me with this. If you ever get involved in sexual immorality, they're going to be judging with the Bible. They remind you that it's immoral to do that, and they derail you. So if you think you're above what the Bible says, you get a problem.
Yeah.
Oh, the whole world, Democrat, Republican, princess, queen, king, the whole world has to be subject to what the Bible says. Because God is the creator. It's not the roadside worker, it's the manufacturer.
Yeah.
And we need to know that.
Yeah.
If you don't know that, I don't care if you don't like the Bible, don't want the Bible in schools, no problem. Get to the position of authority and mess something up, you're going to be doing well. Where you do something, sexual immorality, that's... Where did you find it? In the Bible!
Right.
That you don't like. And the person will be shamed. Let the Bible be your guide.
Yeah.
Let the Bible be your guide. Hallelujah.
Thank you,
Jesus. Yeah, Lord is worthy. Glory be to God. Matthew chapter 7, verse 14. Matthew 7, 14. Must start from verse 13. Enter through the narrow gate. For what is the gate? And broad is the road that leads to destruction. Wide is the gate and broad is the road that leads to destruction. So watch out when you see many people going in a different route. Or a different lifestyle, a different kind of thing, like a new thing in the horizon, everybody going in that direction. You have to be extremely careful. Because just because you have a crowd, it doesn't mean it's right.
Amen.
It was a crowd that said, crucify him, crucify him, let his blood be upon us. But the right, no, they were sincerely wrong.
Yes.
Amen.
So don't go with the crowd, go with God.
Amen.
Be led of the Holy Spirit. If it's possible, the very elect will be deceived. Anytime you overlook or you neglect what the Bible says, you open yourself up to deception. It comes with a warranty. Enter through the narrow gate. Wide is the gate and broad is the road that leads to destruction. And many enter through it. But small is the gate and narrow is the road that leads to life. Only a few find it. Watch out for false prophets. They come by you in sheep clothing, but they want their ferocious wolves. How can you watch out for false prophets if what they're telling you is not in line with what the Bible says is false? See, it can be 70% Bible and 30% not Bible. It's still false. It can be 90% Bible and 10% not Bible. It's still false. It can be 99% Bible and 1% not Bible. It's still. Anytime you dilute the word of God with everything. So that's why people fall into sin. Because they hear something that sounds like it's the Bible, but it's half quotation, not the whole quotation.
Yeah.
The devil said, if you claim to be the Son of God, all the turn this rock into bread. He said, it is true, the man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that comes out of the mouth of God. If you claim to be the Son of God, it's not the Son of God. He knows the Son of God. He knows that Jesus is God. He knew that.
Yeah.
But he's trying to tell, well, if you claim to be this, want to do this to prove that you who you said you are. You are children of God. If you are born again, children of God, watching the blood of the Lamb, you have been justified. You have been delivered. You have been set free. You belong to Jesus. You are saved by grace only, through faith only, and in Christ only are you saved. You belong to God. You are a royal priesthood. You are a holy nation. You are a peculiar people. You have been called out of darkness into his marvelous light. I'm not telling you because I don't have nothing to tell you. I'm telling you because it's the truth.
Yeah.
Now you need to agree with it.
Yeah.
Sanctify them through that truth, that word is true.
Yeah.
Stop going like a peon when you are princes and kings.
God.
We have too many peon mentality.
Yeah.
So you can have a big crowd. People shaking, but you don't want to talk about it. Because we already moved the ancient boundary. So that whole thing, there's no man shall see God. So we went to church to fellowship, but there's no sin of God in the sight of your life. Because without that whole thing, there's no man shall see God.
Yeah.
So if you're fornicating and coming into an adultery and doing your own thing, you have a fellowship with yourself and the devil, but not with God. Because God is holy. We need to hear the word of God. And undiluted. Don't water it down, no more milk. Show me for the mature. Why can't you preach like that? God will keep us from to be kept.
That's right.
That's a real power.
You shall receive power after that the Holy Ghost has come upon you. That's the gospel you are. We cannot, God knows we cannot do it ourselves. He said without me, you can do nothing. So tell him we can't do it. And what can tell you? Well, all the things I say in the Holy Spirit. What is that saying in the Holy Spirit? I know you cannot do it. Did you agree with God? When the Holy Spirit was convicted, did you agree with him? Or did you walk into it? With full knowledge. And grieve the Holy Spirit.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Let the word of God be your guide.
Yeah.
Watch out for false prophets. Hallelujah. A good tree cannot bear bad fruit, and a bad tree cannot bear good fruit. Every tree that does not bear good fruit is cut down and thrown into the fire. That's verse 19, verse 20. Those by their fruit you will recognize them. Yes, what I'm going to tell you, there are times when you go to places and they're doing miracles. Miracles by itself does not validate the anointing.
Yeah.
Miracles along with the word of God is what validates the anointing.
Preach, Pastor. Preach.
The Bible says it's possible. Fake miracles to mesmerize you. If it doesn't line up with the word of God, leave it alone.
Yeah.
And so, let me show you. Oh, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah. Not everyone that says, God, God, enter the kingdom of heaven, but then that does the will of my Father which is in heaven. So there are so many people that are going to churches in which the word is not being preached. Everything they preach is watered down. You don't want to offend anybody. People committing adultery, you don't want to preach against it because the church will be empty. Adultery, fornication, homosexuality. Men marrying men, women marrying women, changing the order of sex. God said, God made them male and female. But you change the male to female, so you make it the female and female. It's not politically correct, but that's the word of God.
Yeah.
It's not going to change for anybody.
Yeah.
Don't move the ancient boundary.
Yeah.
Let the church be the church, walking in the power of the anointing.
Yeah.
The anointing is costly. You got to walk in holiness.
Yeah.
You cannot do what you feel like doing. You should expect to be anointed by who?
Yeah.
By who? And nothing will kill you if you're not walking in holiness.
My God. Preach, Pastor.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Verse 21. Not everyone that said to me, this is Matthew 7:21. Lord, Lord, we enter the kingdom of heaven, but only those who do the will of my Father who is in heaven. Thank you, Jesus. Many will say to me, Lord, do you not prophesy in your name and drive out demons and perform miracles? Do you not prophesy in your name and drive out demons and perform miracles? He said, depart from me, I know you not. You can perform miracles, but not you're not recognizing my name. You're not walking in holiness. You're doing things out of context. Not working with God. Not because you do a miracle. Isn't that what the Bible said?
Yeah.
Seven sons of Sceva. They were casting out devils. They didn't have a relationship with God until the devil found them out and whooped them. They have no relationship. In the name of Jesus, that Paul preaches, come out. And devil was coming out. Not because you cast out devil does not make you godly. Wow, it's quiet today. Do not do miracles in your name. Cast out, drive out demons and perform miracles in your name. Then I will tell them plainly, verse 23. I never knew you away from me. You walk off iniquity or evildoers. Evildoers. Thank you, Jesus. Verse 26. But everyone who hears this word of mine and does not put them into practice like a foolish man. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. I might as well go to verse 24 of it. Matthew 7:24, therefore, everyone who hears this word of mine and put them into practice is like a man who built his house on the rock. The rain come down, the stream rose, and the wind blew and beat against the house, and yet it did not fall, because it had the foundation of the rock. Everyone who hears this word of mine and put it into practice. If you don't read the Bible, how are you going to put it into practice what you don't read?
Yeah.
If all you do is listen to songs, but they are gospel songs, what kind of life is the person living that singing the song? What if you tell you're climbing on the rugged side of the mountain when the Bible says to cast out the devils? Do you understand what I'm saying? The Bible says if you have a faith of that faith, mustard grain seed, you shall say, you shall speak, say to the mountain to move. For somebody sang a song, you're climbing on the rugged side of the mountain. But it's a Christian song. So you're trying to climb because the life is based on the song, not on the word.
Hey, glory.
You got it wrong.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah!
Hey.
Praise his holy name today.
Hey.
God have a great plan for your life!
Yes.
When I looked this morning, I was looking in the sky. You know what I was looking for? The star. Why can't you find the star in the afternoon? Because it's bright sunny. When does the star shine the best? At night. When it's very, very dark.
Yeah.
The darker it is, the brighter the stars shine. In the midst of a crooked and perverted generation, shine as stars.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
It's a shine as stars. So as you hold on firmly to the word of life, that's the way we're going to remain shining. Otherwise, it won't shine for long.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. I'm going somewhere.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you.
Every scripture I share, I'm going to be going there so you can have a look at what I'm talking about. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord
Jesus.
Thank you.
Philippians chapter 2, verse 12. Philippians 2, 12. Thank you, Jesus. Make sure you listen attentively. Amen. If you can write the note fast, write it. If not, listen. Amen. Thank you, Philippians chapter 2, verse 12. Hallelujah. He alone is worthy. Worthy to be praised. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise his holy name.
Hallelujah.
Therefore, my dear friends, as you have always obeyed not in my presence, but much more in my absence, continue to walk out your salvation with fear and trembling. With fear and trembling. Philippians chapter 2, verse 12. He said, don't put up a show when you get to church. When you are with God's people, obey me. When you're not with them in his absence, do exactly what he did.
Yeah.
When you're with God's people.
Mm-hmm.
That's what you call a non-hypocrite person.
Mm-hmm.
When you can obey God with or without the crowd. With nobody's watching, still walk with God.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
After all watching.
Amen.
Walk out your own salvation with fear and trembling. Listen to me. When the Bible says walk out your own salvation, it's not trying to get you to walk for salvation. No. It's saying that which is already in you, let there be evidence of fruit in your life. Where is the fruit that you bring that you say? Where is the fruit? Where is love? Are you saved? Are you mean? You've been saved for 20 years, you still mean as a yard dog. Where is the fruit?
Yeah.
Walk out your own salvation with fear and trembling. Where is the fruit? Therefore, my dear friends, as you have always obeyed, not only in my presence, but much more in my absence. See, some people, when they see the supervisor, they work very, very hard. As soon as the supervisor leaves, they start slacking. Why? Because it is eye service.
Yeah.
Paul said, don't do that in the Christian world.
Amen.
When you see me, work very hard.
Amen.
When you don't see me, still be obedient.
Amen.
So our obedience is not based on what we see each other, it's based on loving God and obeying God. You have to be kind to your spouse. You cannot be mean to your spouse. How can you love God that you don't see when you don't love the one that you see? See, that's the word. Hallelujah. You have to be kind. Walk out of salvation with fear and trembling. He didn't say for you, he said by grace only, through faith only, are you saved. So it's by grace of God you say it. But he said, I want Annie to see some evidence of salvation in your life. I want to see some fruit. What make a tree a good tree? Because it bear fruit. If you like orange and you have an orange tree that never bear orange, you never have orange. What if you go to Eckes Apple? And you pay some money to plant some apple, and there's no apples on the tree, will you get the money back or not? Who do you know that like fruit and go to the store and pay and don't bring the fruit out? Jesus paid for our life in full. He said, now I want some fruit.
Amen.
My God.
Let go of all offenses, otherwise you never bear fruit.
Yes.
Fruit of God don't grow in fruit of unforgiveness, they don't grow together.
Sir.
Let go of all offenses.
Sir.
Some of us are. We are feeling on our sleeves. You can preach it too tired to get offended. If you don't like what you're hearing, I forgive you. I promise you. I forgive you. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. Therefore, friends, as you have always obeyed, not only in my presence, but much more in my absence, continue to walk out of salvation with fear and trembling. For it is God who works in you to will and act in order to fulfill his good pleasure. Verse 14, do everything without grumbling.
Yeah.
We have a grumbling sense on the job. I can hardly wait, they tell you, I can hardly wait for Friday to be here. Sins of the Most High God.
Right.
Grumbling about everything.
Yeah.
Yeah. They ain't liking this. They ain't, what do you like? If you get a job, you complain. If you don't have a job, you complain. What do you want God to do?
Right.
When you complain, don't say anything. Whatever you say, that's not what's going to tell the boss. If you are not lying by now, you need to keep your mouth shut and don't complain with anybody. They tell you what they tell the boss what to say so you can get a promotion on your behalf at your expense.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus. Do not grumble. It's very easy to complain. You know that? Very, very easy to grumble about everything. If you're going to grumble, come up with a solution.
Yeah.
You can come up with a solution.
Yeah.
Zip it. That will help us think in the right direction.
Yeah.
People are chronic complainers. I mean, chronic complainers. They know they are going to work and to help people complain about what they are in liking. Well, we don't have enough help. We don't have this. Listen, if we don't have enough help, I understand it. But don't complain. Pray. Talk to them in love and speak the truth in love. That's how to handle this, but don't complain about it in the back. And join the group to go against authority.
Right.
Why are you waiting on the anointing of God to be upon your life? Do everything without grumbling or arguing, so that you may become blameless and pure children of God without fault in the wrath in the midst of a warped and wicked generation. Listen to this. Then you will shine among them like stars in the sky, as you hold firmly to the word of life. As you hold firmly to the word of life. You shine as stars as you hold firmly to the word of life. If you want to shine, the word will shine. That's what shining through you, so that you hold firmly to what the Bible says. That's what makes you shine. Holding firmly to what the Bible says, that's what makes you shine. They told Daniel, they're going to put him in the lion's den. If he prayed to God, what did he do? He prayed to God because he was holding firmly to the word of life.
Hey.
That was supposed to be fair to the lion, shine.
Hey, hallelujah.
He shined like stars.
Hey,
he got a promotion out of something that's supposed to kill him because he held up to what the Bible says.
Hallelujah.
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 Oh,
hallelujah.
This last week I went through kind of changes. I like to listen to Fox News and different things just to keep track of what's going on. And there was a male, who's a lady, who had the bodyguard, who's a male, and the male went and slept around with the bodyguard, and then they tried to shame the male and everything else. And listen to me. The pleasure of sin is 5 minutes. But they have eternity to deal with the small pleasure of it. Let us weigh it in our life. And let us weigh it so heavily.
Yes.
The reason why people lose is because they don't weigh it. They don't count the cost. They got blinded by the devil to think it's a big price.
Mm-hmm.
But it's a very, very little benefit. Because
yeah.
If you have no benefit at all, you won't be doing it. Is that going to give you a benefit of 3 minutes? And you have your lifetime to compare with that when you put a permanent scar in your life for 3 minutes pleasure. The Bible says the pleasure of sin is for a season. Very, very short season.
Yeah.
Very, 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 very short season. Wow. They were trying to give you a dollar and take a trillion out of your life.
Amen. Yeah.
Different. What's the difference between a dollar and a trillion? So much. When Christ died on the cross for all our sins, guess what? You are priceless.
Yeah.
Devil said, wait a minute. Devil is very jealous of us. Do you understand it?
Yeah.
He was trying to get the glory. They kick him out of heaven. You're not asking for it, they crown you with glory and honor. Without asking for it. So when the devil sees you in the spirit, like, wait a minute. I can't believe it, man. This means that I ain't complete. Don't even keep everything that Bible says. You shower them with your blessing. You send them by your own grace. You wash them in your own blood. You send them on the high ground. I can't believe it. Let me go and trick them. Yeah, come on. Look at this. This is good. Anybody gonna say? Anybody gonna see you? Yeah, come on, do it. Anybody gonna see you? The problem is this. If you understand that the devil is a liar, then why do you believe? Well, I'm gonna tell you nobody's gonna see.
Right.
But the secret is the problem on the rooftop. If someone's on the rooftop, don't do it on the secret.
Amen. Preach it, Pastor.
I was in St. Louis many years ago. And they're having a revival. So they said everybody should fast for the following days. They said because it's going to be a miracle day. Casting out devil and everything there. So everybody should fast to come before they come to the revival the second day. So they said, Austin looking guy, maybe 250 pounds. They didn't fast. When the night came, they were trying to cast out devils. While trying to cast out devil, he was so arrogant. He said, wait a minute, I got this one. And he put his hand on the guy. And he said, stuck on there. They couldn't get his hand off. They had to pray him off. Preacher had to ask him, wait a minute. You didn't fast. And if you don't pray you off, you're going to be stuck right there. Mm-hmm. I don't care if you're 300 pounds, you're going to be stuck right there. It's not by power, but by my spirit.
Yeah, glory.
You don't cast out the devil because you're husky looking.
Right.
No. Mm-hmm. You don't have the power to cast out the devil as the power of God.
Yeah.
And if you're not obedient to God, then you send yourself for a failure.
Yeah.
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 Here you're going out on the field, on minefield with no ammo. And then surprise you get hit. You're going to get hit. If you don't obey what the Bible says, you open yourself up for the enemy to tread anywhere. You get the permission for the enemy. You get the door, the key to your door to just walk in and out as well. When you don't do what God says.
Jesus.
Sir.
My God.
Hallelujah.
And then you're surprised when something happens. Mm-hmm. Don't be surprised. Give him the key. Get the key back from him through the repentance. Get the key back.
Hallelujah.
If we confess our sins, God is faithful to forgive us of all our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. The problem is if we confess.
Yes, sir.
The systems of people are trailing behind them. If it's trailing, they think God doesn't know. So therefore, they don't confess anything. Look like they cover for a little while. Nobody knows anything about anything. Matter of time, before the sin catch up.
Yes,
God's name will slow you down until the devil catch up.
Yes.
If you're driving on the highway and you take a piece of the gas pedal, no. You might look like it's going, but surely I ain't gonna be going for long. Even if you're going downward slow, it won't run downward slow forever. There's a friction that demands that you put your leg on the gas pedal, otherwise it's gonna come to a halt eventually. So it's surprise coming to a halt because of unrepentance sin. It will come to a halt. It comes to a warranty.
Yes, sir.
Let the word of God be your guide.
Mm-hmm.
Nobody have to know what we did before we repent. Talk to him.
Yes.
Make a man with God. Walk with God for real.
Yes.
And take a walk with God with seriousness.
Yeah.
And start playing with your life.
Yeah.
Just because everybody is doing it. You have to prove that I've been saved for a long time. They always have a nice time. What I do is aligning with the word of God. If the answer is no, you leave it alone. But the Bible says if it's possible, the very end, let you be deceived.
Mm-hmm.
Why? Because it lets us go with the crowd and not with the word.
Amen. That's the word.
Let the Bible be your guide.
Hey,
right. The Bible says, shine as stars. Among them, shine as stars in the sky. As a whole family, as old family. You want to shine the stars with the old family. That's what the Bible says. Old family. Don't something family means to not let go of it. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. He alone is worthy. Thank you, Jesus. I remember when I started riding the bike in Nigeria, the bike I ride is bigger than me. The bike I ride was bigger than me. So I had to go on the side where you have this, something high to sit down on it. But my leg would not touch the ground. But I enjoyed going down the slope. Zzz, I mean, if it goes, it breeze. The problem is, if I want to stop, I have to find a place to hit so I can stop. And now the question is closer enough. God is so wonderful. We have no helmet. Not just driving around. You could have been killed very easily. I'm serious.
Yes, sir.
You go to the. You take the bike up there because you can't ride it up because you're up the hill. And then go by the side of the road and try to climb on it. And then just kind of ride down. It's good, but gotta hold on to the handlebar. If you let the handlebar go, you can go anywhere. I mean, can kill somebody. I'm serious. At a high speed.
Yes.
So God, Bible says, hold on to the water pipe. So you can shine the stars. You wanna shine? Hold on.
Yeah.
You wanna shine? Hold on. Because if you let go, all you have to go like this one time. That's it, man.
Yeah.
One people by the cat wheel. Only 2 minutes. Thank you. So, even though he's feeling the breeze and everything, even though I could not reach the ground, the pedal, but God, I don't want it. You gotta hold on to this. Don't make sure it doesn't go any which way. If it goes to one splashing and it still has ice cream, trying to turn a little bit, you know? Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Yeah, Lord is worthy. So many people want to shine a star, they start shining, but they go to the water fly and they stop shining. It's called perversion.
My God.
They start shining. But as long as you hold on, family, hold on, family. In the motorboat, you try to do water ski. You hold on, you might have splashes and everything coming in your face. You gotta hold on, because if you don't, you kill yourself. You might not like the splashes in your face, and it's going every which way, but hold on, matter of time, the ride will come to an end soon. I got the 6 flags. A lot of people are afraid to ride. I like ninja. I sit down it. One thing I have in mind, I close my eyes and relax. If you relax any which way you go, you're in. But if you tense up, you're going to have a whoop-lash when you finish. When you start going up the hill, some other time, it's going to come down this way. You understand? But it's going down the hill. Oh, you can just see it. Can. When you go like this, you better hold on and relax. I said, hold on.
Yeah.
Because you're in for the ride. It goes every which way. But straight.
Hallelujah.
But if you keep on holding on, you know what happened? The ride comes to an end. Christ is coming back soon.
Yeah.
Hey, hold on to the water fly.
Yeah.
That which you have learned, that which you have heard from me and had in the word of God, hold on to it and the peace of God will be with you. Commit the word to people that are faithful, that will hold on to what the Bible says, no matter what anybody says.
Yeah,
what
yeah,
thank you, Jesus. Nice. Shine our stars. People say we shine our stars, but they don't want to hold on. If you stop holding on, you stop shining. The word is the one that makes us shine. The word of God is what makes us shine.
Yeah.
If you hold families to the word, you shine. If you let go of the word, you stop shining. Why? The word of God is the light.
Yeah.
It's the light. If you take the glitter out of the shining, there will be no shining.
Yeah.
Now what is left on my feet and the light on my
body?
Jesus. He alone is worthy. Worthy to be praised. Glory be to God. Matthew 24, let's take a look at Matthew 24. Amen. That's like Matthew is my very friend. Thank you, Jesus. Glory be to God.
Verse 23.
Amen. Matthew 24:23. Something happened one time that's very interesting, and I couldn't believe my eyes. You have a group in St. Lucia that was waiting for somebody to come from Florida, and they said that man is Messiah. They're going to be Messiah. So the guy had to fly from Florida to get here. I'm not trying to be funny. People were waiting in the temple for the Messiah to come. and he flew from Florida to get here. If you had to fly in the plane, it's not the right one. Do not be deceived. It sounds very funny, but that's so true. After the wedding in St. Louis here, for him to come, they said that's the Messiah. The piece was packed, waiting for the Messiah. A time we're going to say, yeah, this is the desert, don't go there.
Right.
It's over there, don't go there. For the lightning strike, shine. Lightning strike in the east, you see it in the west. So shall the Son of Man come. Yeah. The cloud had to break open. If it's not coming from above,
yeah.
With the power of his majesty, it's not the right one.
Yeah.
If you had to catch a plane, you can miss a plane.
Yeah.
Don't find body not in the plane. You understand that? It's only God for the fear of you.
Yeah.
It's a greeting.
Yeah,
sure. If you say, oh, it's over there. Christ is in California, like, they do all kinds of miracles. I know it. Put him on CBN and CNN and look at it. Look at the number. Who is the Christ? And then we start flying there. Who is it? Because there are people that are mesmerized by what we see.
Yeah, yeah.
What happened to the inner witness of the Holy Ghost? You shall receive power after that the Holy Ghost has come upon you and shall be my witnesses. Don't be deceived. The spirit of truth will never agree with a lie. I don't care who is doing monkey flip and the cat wheel. If you don't sense peace in your heart that God is leading you by the spirit, then don't go.
That's right.
Don't get caught in the wrong place at the wrong time.
Right.
Because go with the crowd and not with God.
Yeah,
thank you, Jesus. Verse 23, this is Matthew 24, 23. At that time, if anyone said to you, look here, here is the Messiah, or there he is, do not believe it. For false Messiah and false prophet will appear and perform signs and wonders to deceive. False Messiah, false Christ will appear. And do kind of miracles. Why? To deceive. It's a miracle that set people for deception. But God said, oh, it's over here. Oh, it's in Kansas City. Oh, it's in San. I'm telling you, it's in San Luis. Son! And know the Messiah. But false prophets and false messiahs, will appear to perform great signs and wonders. So you see, it's possible, even the very elect. See, I've told you ahead of time. If anybody tell you there is he is not in the wilderness, do not go out. There is in the inner room, do not believe it. For the lightning comes from the east and is visible even in the west. So the coming of the Son of Man. Hallelujah.
Yeah,
thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Verse 30, for the sake of time. Then will appear a sign of the Son of Man in heaven. And then all the people on the earth will mourn when they see the Son of Man coming in the clouds of heaven with the power and glory. Hey, he sends angels with a loud trumpet call, and they will gather the elect from all the four winds of the end of the heaven to another. Land out this blessing from the fig tree. As soon as it's quick, get tender and its leaves turn up, you know that summer is near.
Yeah.
Even though when all this begins to happen, know it's near, right at the door. Hallelujah, right at the door. He's saying, nobody knows the time and the day that Christ will come back.
Yeah.
But if you're a saint, you can sense it by the Spirit. Like, oh, something's happening to me. I don't know what is happening, but I know he's coming back soon.
Yeah.
I can just sense it by the Spirit.
Lord.
I can just say that. Because I will not do anything without telling my friend.
Yeah.
You are my friend if you do what I tell you to do, not if you just show up in church.
Amen.
Right.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Yes,
he alone is worthy.
Right.
Glory be to God in the highest.
Right.
On that peace be unto all men. On whom his favor rests.
Right.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. It's near. Right at the door. I take this generation shall not pass away until all these things have happened. Heaven and earth shall pass away, but my word will never pass away. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Yeah.
So we have to be careful. Don't say it will happen instantly. It's not something that will happen. It's not something that will give you a time. So say you're sorry, you might be driving. If you're driving at the show, if you're in, you're in, you're gone. We have a driverless car. If you fly the plane and you're a pilot and you show up, you're gone.
Yeah.
You're going to have a plane with no pilot.
Yeah.
I like that movie. Left Behind. preacher was preaching. Everybody left and said, the preacher, and the preacher said, I know your word. Then why are you still here, partner? I know your word. So whatever I preach to you, I have to leave. God is using me to preach to us. I'm preaching to you. Trust me, I don't want to be here while everybody's gone. I'm talking about, I know your word. Then why are you still here? Brother, what are you doing? I know your word. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Yeah, the Lord is worthy. Worthy to be. Galatians chapter 1. Amen. Verse 6, Galatians chapter 1, verse 6. This is very, very interesting. Amen. Galatians chapter 1, verse 6. I'm astonished. And I'm so quickly, that you are so quickly deciding the one who called you to live in the grace of Christ and are turning to a different gospel, which is not gospel at all. Let's say I'm astonished. I'm flabbergasted. I can't believe that you're turning from the real gospel to something that is not a gospel at all. Yeah. It sounds good, but it's not a gospel at all. So people are going to, a lot of people are going to church today to hear what suit their ear, which is not gospel at all. Something that will make you comfortable in your sin is not the gospel.
Amen.
If you make you comfortable in sin, it's not a gospel. Amen. Trust me. It's not the doctrine of the devil. Doctrine that make you comfortable when you're doing your own thing. I'm astonished that you are so quickly deciding. Quickly deciding. Why? Because it's not what they want to hear. There's a quickly deciding of what the Bible says to what you feel like you ought to say. Hallelujah. Quickly deciding the one who called you to live in the grace of Christ and attend to a different gospel, which is really no gospel at all. Every some people are throwing you into confusion and trying to pervert the gospel of Christ. Anytime you try to introduce something that is against what the Bible says, you try to pervert the gospel of Christ.
Yeah.
If you have to make room for adultery and fornication and greed and unforgiveness and supposed to be okay with Christ, just that you perverted the gospel. Mm. You say it's okay to be mean to your spouse and still be godly. Mm. It's okay to be greedy and steal and lie and chew and smoke and fornication and adultery and still be godly.
My God.
And still be godly. Verse 7, which is really not gospel at all. Evidence of people are throwing you into confusion and are trying to pervert the gospel of Christ. But even if we or an angel from heaven should preach a gospel other than the one which is preached to you, let it be eternally under God's curse, eternally condemned. Wow. If somebody preaches something that not what the Bible says, let them be eternally condemned. Wow. That's a powerful thing. He said, even we, or anybody is telling you, preaching the gospel, that don't know what the Bible says, let them be eternally condemned. That's too heavy. That's very heavy. He said, even we. He included himself. Because he understands that it's important that you hear the gospel.
Yeah.
The gospel may not feel good, but that's the gospel.
Yeah.
If you're a minister of the gospel, then you should be a minister of the gospel. Minister of the gospel.
Yeah.
It's not popular to preach what the Bible says, because people step on so many toes. People that don't want to change will hate you. They snare instead of being. Because they ain't ready to change. He's stepping on their toes. They ain't ready for that. Because there are some people are throwing you into confusion and are trying to pervert the gospel of Christ. But even we, an angel from heaven, if we preach the gospel, all that what the Bible says, may be eternally condemned. Wow. Thank you, Jesus. As I clearly said, we say it again, verse 9. If anybody is preaching to you a gospel other than what you have accepted, let them be under God's curse, eternally condemned. Verse 10 is what's going to explain what I just finished talking about. Verse 10, listen to this. Am I not trying to win the approval of men, human beings, or of God? Am I trying to win the approval of men? See, when you're trying to win the approval of men, you're going to expand the gospel to accommodate immorality and ungodliness. So if you're going to preach the gospel that lines up with God, then you don't be doing it for the approval of men.
Yeah.
See, that doesn't go with politics, does it? You want a high approval. You can have a zero approval of men, but 100% approval of God is wonderful.
Yeah, glory.
So if you're trying to get the approval of men, they're going to deviate from the message. But men that want to work in perversity don't like holiness. So we want to hire a group of men just to accommodate everything. Let everything go. I'm not talking about everything, I'm going to give you a big tithe.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Even a big about scripture, somebody else's wife, you can't talk about it because if you do the mess, stop coming to church. I was trying to build a new building so you don't go to skip. Like an elephant in your living room, you dance around it, you don't want. You sweep around it.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
If anybody preaches gospel, other than the gospel which is preached to you, may they be eternally condemned. You see? In order for you not to preach the real gospel, don't look for approval of men. Am I not trying to win approval of men or of God? It just I'm telling you the condition in which you can deviate from preaching the gospel. When you try to win the approval of men. You have a nice good music and you have a good fellowship with everybody else, but no word. So I'm just looking for a church where you can really have a nice good music and something for everybody. Okay. Praise the Lord. We get one of those. Where they can accommodate anybody. You can be sleeping with somebody until you find another boyfriend or another girlfriend. While you're waiting on the Lord to get a spouse, you're tripping around and dipping and diving, but it's okay, you're waiting on the Lord. Everybody knows nobody is perfect and praise the Lord. Approval of men. You can't touch it. If the preacher himself tripping and sliding, you can't preach about holiness. You know what I found out? When people do something, they find it difficult to preach on it.
Yeah.
When people are tripping, they find it difficult to preach on that issue, they kind of dance around it. Sometimes they talk about something that the marriage should be holy. A well known preacher said, oh, the Bible is silent about it. Says who? The Bible is never silent about holiness and godliness in marriage. Well known preacher said, the Bible is silent about this. What kind of Bible have you been reading? Trying to deviate from them because of people pressure on their limelight. People will hate you. If you talk about things that are not things that God hates.
Amen.
You have no approval rating with men. And with real approval rating, you have a candidate that can Rolls Royce you're trying to pay for. So don't preach about godliness. Because you found your right to hell.
Hallelujah.
Let the Bible be your guide. Am I not trying to win approval of man or of God? Am I trying to please people? If I'm just trying to please people, I will not be a servant of Christ. If I'm just trying to please people, I will not be a servant of Christ. So if I'm trying to please you, I'm going to be off. I'll be serving you, but not God.
Yeah.
So I'm not being a preacher of the gospel anymore. Preacher of the gossip. Preacher to look everybody had that. Well, you have a big crowd, candidate for hell, big candidates. Big is the way. Why does it rule like this? Everything goes. Nothing but the righteous, you see God.
Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah.
That's the word, Pastor.
Hallelujah. And he said, I'm not trying to win the approval of man or of God. If anybody brings to the gospel, other than what is written, what the Bible says, it's even if we deviate from what the Bible says, or any other person, even if it's an angel from heaven, can't break up to see the angel. Oh, God's going to do something. If what he says, it's not lying up with what the Bible says, let him be that eternally condemned. I don't believe it. Why? Because if it's possible, the very end to be deceived. Don't go see signs and wonders. How was the last time? Is it possible for a miracle? Is he sleeping with somebody else's wife and then do signs and wonders and then you follow them? Where are you going with them? Hallelujah. Let the Bible be your guide. Do not move the ancient boundary. The ancient boundary is what the Bible says. Don't move it. Don't add to the word of God. If you add to God, you add a plague in the Bible to that person's life. Don't take it from the word of God. If you do, God will remove that person's name from the Lamb book of life.
Wow.
Don't add to the world, let's be come a liar, because it won't come to pass, because you add your own life. God don't need my input. Let the world be the world.
Yeah,
let the world be the world. Don't be anything, that's what it meant. Pray for that the fivefold use of that's what it meant. Don't hold a grudge and go to eternity without forgiveness and bitterness.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Let the Bible be your guide.
Yeah.
Let the Bible be your guide. Let the Bible be your guide.
Hallelujah.
One verse of the scripture. And thank you, Jesus. Glory be to God. He knows his body today. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Colossians 3:15. That's the last scripture. In closing, I'm not going to close many times. In closing. Colossians 3:15. Let the peace of God or peace of Christ rule in your heart. Let the peace of Christ rule in. How can the peace of Christ rule when you're not walking with Him? The Bible says there's no peace for the wicked.
Yeah.
So if you're not walking with God, I guarantee you, the peace of God will never rule in your heart. Why? Because there's no peace for the wicked. So people that are not walking, we're talking about our sense peace. You're about to make the greatest mistake in your life.
Yeah.
Because the peace you sense is yours, not God's peace. Hallelujah. Get him, but the ghost, get him. He's too quiet in there. I can hear a pin drop. Let me drop a pin. Where's it? Find the pin for me. Let the peace of Christ rule in your heart. Let the peace of God be the umpire. Since as members of one body, you are called to peace. I'm be thankful. Verse 16. Let the message of Christ or the word of God dwell in you richly among as you teach and admonish one another. Through all wisdom and psalms and hymns and songs from the Spirit, singing to God with gratitude in your heart. Let the message of Christ dwell in you richly. Let what God dwell in you richly. Let you, if you don't have the Bible, time to read the Bible, and you don't have the time to come to church to hear the word, how can it dwell in you richly? See, when dwelling in you richly, that is the honor of heart, the mouth speaks. If there's nothing in the heart, then there's nothing to hold up. There's no measurement of holiness. Because sanctify them through that truth, that what is true. That what is true, that what is true. Let the Bible be your guide. It sounds very, very simple. But when everybody's against what the Bible says on your job, do you go along with them? So God don't want them to persecute you. Do you go along with them at school, at work, wherever you go? Do you kind of meddle in the cousin and swearing? And you don't want to be an odd person out. You can't just grin. You kind of sit there and grin. And you come back tomorrow and fellowship with the same group of person that's swearing. Let the Bible be your guide. When the Bible is your guide, you're going to shine a star. But hold on, family. To the word of life. Word of family. Let it go, word of life. Try to shine. Don't try to shine without the word.
Amen.
The word is a lamp to my feet and the light to my eyes. See, I close for you in closing. I'm not going to say, in closing.